Hey everyone, welcome back to the Bandwagon. Luis here with Matt and of course Julie, the star of the show. We're getting back to our roots today. We're going to be talking about standard bans.
Yeah.
There was a recent announcement that there's going to be an additional ban list announcement, an announcement of an announcement, here on October 21st, which is about a month earlier than expected. Basically, Wizards is reserving the right to ban something. Not an emergency ban, because they announced it, but they're reserving the right to ban something at a time that it normally wouldn't.
If they ban something there, that will be an emergency ban, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, I mean, as far as they're concerned, it wouldn't, though.
Sure.
But basically, by saying, hey, we're going to make an additional ban announcement, a ban-restricted announcement, technically, but they already said they're not going to touch Vintage, because Eternal Weekend is coming up so soon.
So not restricted.
We could only assume that this is has to do with Standard, because that also, that timing, gives people enough time to test for the Mythic Championship in Richmond, Mythic Championship 6, and they would only do that, I think, if they thought there was a serious problem with Standard.
Yeah.
Hint, there is a serious problem with Standard. Both of us have been testing quite a bit for Mythic Championship 5, you because you're playing in it, me because Gabby's playing in it. And, you know, all those hours of Standard have kind of led us to the conclusion that the Golos deck is a problem.
Yeah, it is a lot.
Yeah, you know, see, there we go. The dog knows where her bread gets buttered. Good dog. Come here, Jules. Oh, yeah, there we go. So, what do you think is going to happen? I mean, I think most people assume Field of the Dead is on the chopping
board. Yeah, so my impression of what will happen, this is a prediction, not necessarily what I hope happens, is that it will be just Field of the Dead. It's really hard to ban additional cards like potentially Oko or other
things. Circuitous Route, Growth Spiral.
Right. These are other cards from the Field deck. Field just seems like such an obvious choice.
Yeah, and I think that in the past, it historically has not gone well to try to ban the enablers instead of the problem card. You do that a lot of the time. First of all, it doesn't kill the deck.
Yes.
Imagine if you ban Circuitous Route and the deck just, you know, turned into like a Jund version that just plays more removal or something.
Right, or there's another ramp spell in the next set, and then all of a sudden you have the same problem again. And so, like, it's just really risky to do that.
Right. So, I think where we're at is the most likely outcome is Field of the Dead gets banned.
Right.
And nothing else. Exactly.
Right.
Field of the Dead.
And so, so they could also ban something from another deck, but because Golos has been so dominant recently, it's so hard to evaluate. Would blue-green food be too much if Golos were banned? Is there some, like, play pattern concerns with other decks? Is there other stuff? It's so hard to evaluate any of that because Golos is just blocking all that out. We have almost very little data even on these other decks.
And also what they would look like if Golos wasn't in the format.
Right, how warped are these blue-green food decks? Do they have to play like a bunch of evasive creatures and like four questing beasts because of this, but otherwise they could be built this way or... Yeah,
right.
It's just
or,
all tough.
Or how like, you know, Esper made a kind of a brief jump start at the beginning of winning Phantom Legends the first week.
Yeah, but the Doom Foretold.
But for the most part, Esper's just a bad strategy against Golos.
Right.
If Field of the Dead was gone, well, we might see a resurgence of Esper. It's got a lot of good cards.
And if the Doom Foretold Esper deck is the best deck, that's a really scary place to be because that deck is also not the most fun to play against.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of risks here, but it's too hard to evaluate,
so,
I think.
What would you do if you had the choice?
So, it's tough. The Esper thing is a big risk, but I feel like the Esper deck can be attacked with, like, pressure plus negates, things like that. Like, when you build a deck that's, like, I don't know if linear is the right word exactly, but, like, has such kind of a focus strategy and is, like, completely creatureless, has some vulnerabilities, it feels like it's unlikely that that deck's going to be, like, able to just dominate.
Yeah, one of the issues, I think, with the Golos deck is you can't really interact with Field of the Dead.
Right.
And, you know, as someone who's tried a bunch of discard, a bunch of counterspells, that kind of stuff, it doesn't really work. Like, that's not the correct way, or not even not the correct way. There isn't a correct way to really hate on Golos besides building your entire deck to beat it.
But with Doom Foretold, Dance of the Mance, those type of things, like, you can...
Yeah, Hand Disruption's good against them.
And,
you know?
And Negate is good.
Duress is good. Counterspells tend to be pretty good.
Right.
I don't think Esper is something to consider.
It's a concern, potentially. It is a little scary, and it would be bad if it were 20% of the field, 15% of the field even, but I think that's not too likely. The biggest concern to me is blue-green food, and in particular, Oko. Oko, blue-green food is actually the kind of deck that you'd look to be a top dog, right? It's a mid-range kind of style deck.
Yeah, it plays much creatures.
Has a good play pattern, plays interactive games. They're long, but not as long as the Golos games. They're like kind of a healthy... They're kind of what you would expect a top dog in Standard to be, the traditional Jund, Abzan type of thing. The issue is just specifically Oko pushes out so many things. There's these cool legendary artifacts coming out with Eldraine. They're not great when they get turned into 3/3s. The Great Henge I've seen less and less of as the format has developed. And
despite being a card that's actually not that bad against Golos. Like,
right.
Like, if
right.
you resolve the Great Henge against Golos, it's, like, you feel good about that.
Right, right. But, yeah, just getting that Oko'd is just pretty right. Oko demoralizing.
Can nuke that, turn into a 3/3 legendary elk, which means if they play their other Great Henge, they even have to sack their elk still.
Yeah, yeah. And similarly, big creatures are, have a similar issue. You know, anything, any like feasting troll kings or whatever cool big creatures are coming out are also like going to lose a lot of their luster when playing against Oko. If you play Oko and plus it, all of a sudden I don't want to play my 3/3 creature, that's also a pretty big feel bad, like,
right, because all of a sudden you end up with a food, the person with Oko ends up with a 3/3.
Yeah, yeah, like there's some cool cards like Savvy Hunter, even, that's like a pretty cool card and it's pretty pushed, but if they play an Oko and plus it and you play that, you almost lost the game on the spot,
right? And I think that the fact that Oko just pluses to get out of range too, I mean,
yes,
even playing something like Gruul, which is pretty aggressive against Oko, if they play it and plus it, it's 6 loyalty. Often you either can't kill it or it uses their whole turn to kill it there, and they end up with a food.
But the one that I find the funniest is Fry. There's a 2-mana card that's sole purpose is to kill blue and white planeswalkers, and somehow a 3-mana blue planeswalker can get out of range immediately.
Yeah, that's pretty wild.
It's mind-blowing to me. Absolutely.
You'd think frying food would actually be good. Like, that just tends to work out well.
Yeah, you'd think so. So, one way or another, Oko is pretty obnoxious. It's the loyalty, it's the just turning, making it kind of irrelevant what your opponent's doing, pushing out big things, which I think it's really cool when those big things are, big flashy plays are playable in Standard. And so, you know, it's tough to predict, would it be dominant if Golos got banned? I think there's a decent chance, but even if not, this card is just not that fun.
Yeah.
And so, in a way, I think it's kind of, it's tough because it's a new mythic, like, they're, you know,
yeah, it's not good practice
reluctant
to do that.
Yeah, they're reluctant to ban that, and for good reason. It hurts consumer confidence every time you do that. A lot of people have spent $100 on a playset of Okos and would lose them, but I would be inclined to ban Oko as well as Field, even though, again, I think it's unlikely to actually happen.
Yeah, I think from a power level perspective, definitely want to ban Field. I think that's a given. We're very much on that page. I think you can let Oko slide. My concern is that a metagame where 30% of decks are playing Oko just seems like a not very fun one. I think were there not price considerations, I would ban Oko.
Yeah.
I think that would be lead to the most fun standard.
Yeah.
Ban Field, let it ban Oko. I don't think that's going to happen. I think I think we all pretty much understand that's just not likely to be on the table.
Yeah, I know I got a stat from the Star City that I think in day 2, 60% of the decks had Oko, and that's with a lot of Golos decks that mostly don't have Oko.
Yeah,
I think
some have them in the sideboard. But
like, what does that say about a once field? I think it's going to be more than 30.
You think it's going to be like 50% Oko?
I think so.
It is very good. I mean, you take out one of the pillars of Standard, this, like, blue-green was the obvious best place to start before Golos. Golos obviously got there and became better. Yeah, I mean, that is definitely something to think about. I guess the official bandwagon position is we would ban both.
Yeah, I think that's fair. So, prediction, just Field gets banned. Hope, both Field and Oko get banned.
Yeah. I do want to point out, though, by the way, since we are on ChannelFireball.com, if you buy any card from ChannelFireball.com and it gets banned within 30 days, you can get a full refund in store credit.
So. Yeah, so if you do want to buy Okos or Fields risk-free.
There we go. I just want to throw that out there because if you got a tournament coming up and you want to play Golos, like, this is a way to do it without losing your shirt if Field gets banned. So.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for watching. We'll see what happens in just a couple weeks here. And, I like it when the bandwagon gets to get back to its roots.
Yeah, for sure.